Hey everybody, so I am at Armadillo Boulders down in the heart of San Antonio and getting ready to go inside and hopefully meet up with a good friend of mine, Joe Kreidel. He is one of the owners here, and they just opened this gym about a year ago, so we're gonna go inside, see what's going on. They got, man, this looks so good, and they are in the heart of San Antonio again, near the Pearl District. So I don't know if people know San Antonio or are going to be moving here, but the Pearl District is a very happening new and up and coming area in San Antonio. All right, so let me get on in there. I'll meet up with Joe and then we'll go from there.
Hey Joe, good to see you again. How you doing?
Very good, Mark. Welcome back to Armadillo Boulders.
Yeah, thank you so much. I am so impressed with everything I'm seeing so far.
I can't believe you got this location.
Yeah, we're at a really good spot in downtown San Antonio, right by the Pearl Museum of Art, right by the Riverwalk. So we're really fortunate to be a really fun, vibrant community.
Yeah, I remember when I lived here, this place was really growing.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard to get anything around here.
Yeah, there's still a lot going on, new stuff being built all around us, so yeah. It's exciting.
Yeah, I love everything so far. So, let's get some basic numbers. How big is the gym?
So the gym itself is 11,200 square feet.
It's like
footprint of the gym, the floor plan.
Okay.
And we have about 5,200 square feet of climbing walls.
Okay.
Otherwise, like about 300 linear feet. So if you measure the top of the walls, about 300 linear feet of climbing.
Yeah.
And that translates for us. Typically, we have about 100 to 150 little problems up in time.
150? 100.
Okay.
And you guys just do bouldering, right?
Bouldering only, yeah.
Okay.
No ropes, no harnesses, but you have a great yoga studio, we have a fitness room, we have a climbing training section, as well as a
moon
board, which is extremely popular.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
All that back there.
And I've got a lot of people excited.
Yeah, a lot of people come in just for that. They'll just spend 3 hours sessioning on the moon board, which is great.
Oh, my God.
It's a great way to get strong.
That's what I hear.
Yeah.
I tried it once. There's a guy locally here that has one in his yard back before there were any gyms, and I tried his, and
yeah,
it was hard, man.
Yeah.
Of course, I hadn't been climbing for like 6 years when I tried it.
It's kind of a style all its own. It can be very humbling.
Yeah. No kidding. So how high are your walls? I'm going to show everybody in a minute here, but
Most of our walls are 15 feet above the pads.
Okay.
We have a few sections you'll see where they're a little bit lower, either 13 or 14 feet. But the highest point kind of back there is 15 feet, 4 inches above the pads.
Okay.
We didn't want to go too high. You know, once you start getting 16, 17, 18 feet, as some gyms do, it starts to get a little more dangerous. So we wanted to keep it reasonable, manageable. High enough that you can feel the exposure when you're up there. You know there's consequences, but trying to really limit
the
impact of injury.
I'm still afraid of heights.
Yeah.
And so it's really hard for me to even get up to the 15 sometimes because of my fear, especially the grips.
Yeah.
When I'm going for something that's a little bit harder to hold on to.
Yeah. The nice thing is we do have a really nice wall over there that's really kid friendly. It's only about 13 feet tall. You know, for anybody that's a little more timid, afraid of heights, it's a great place to start.
Yeah.
So tell me about this wall, Joe.
We call this wall Four Corners. It's got several angles going around. It's mostly vertical with a little bit of slab and a little bit of slight overhang. But it's a really good spot for some good dihedrals, a lot of arets, and some fun slab problems. So this is where we try to really push people to learn some good technical skills, use their feet, and learn how to climb fluidly and smoothly.
And then this is your fitness room, it looks like.
Yeah, this is our fitness room. It's pretty well stocked. We've got squat rack, modular rig, kettlebells, dumbbells, all the usual workout equipment, a little bit of cardio. We've got a rower, a bike, an assault runner, which a lot of people really love. And this room gets a lot of use. We've got a climbing fitness class that operates out of here every Tuesday and Saturday. And it's just a good way to get people to round out their workout climbers do a lot of pulling, this is a good place to come in and work on some of those opposing muscles, do some pushing and, you know, leg work.
Yeah, this definitely is a well-outfitted workout area. I know a lot of climbing gyms don't have anything this good, and I'm pretty impressed. I like this. And then over here you got...
We have our yoga studio. We typically have about 12 to 15 yoga classes a week, including Pilates mat classes. We have an ab and core class twice a week. Sometimes we use this as an event space as well. We'll host movie screenings, we'll watch climbing comps, sometimes we'll set up movies for kids. Or people just come in, stretch, they'll do their own thing. People will practice martial arts, or we have swing dancers that come in here and swing dance. So it's kind of a fun space that people use in different ways.
So a good way to bring the community in and let them find out about your gym, if nothing else, and then also have a place to do their activities.
Yeah.
That's great. I'm glad to hear that you guys are interacting with the community that way. Then, all right. So this is some of the cool, really detailed area here. So tell me about this wall right here, Joe.
This area is kind of a unique climbing wall. It's got lots of different angles, fracturing in different ways. And when we were designing it, we also kind of realized it kind of reflected the shells of an armadillo. So we call this wall Bandland, and we changed the design a little bit to kind of incorporate that armadillo theme a little bit. When we started the gym and picked the name Armadillo Boulders, we weren't sure how far we wanted to run with the theme of armadillo. Like,
right.
When we were doing logos, did we want to have an armadillo in our logo? And we tried to not have too much cartoony armadillo stuff, but
right.
the wall already had this kind of armadillo shell feel to it.
Kind of a natural thing kind of going.
We ran with it there.
Speaking of the walls and their design, I noticed that they were vertical solution walls.
Yeah, so these were built by Vertical Solutions based out of Salt Lake City, Utah, who just does an incredible job. They put up these, you know, what could be just simple plywood walls, but they put a lot of thought and detail and attention into all the work. You can see every corner here has like a hardwood inlay.
Yeah.
So throughout the gym, all of our arettes, corners, dihedrals have these really pretty inlays. On another wall, you'll see we have our triangle logo incorporated into a wall in hardwood.
Show that. Yeah, they actually make their walls look like a work of art in wood.
Yeah.
They're very nice.
The detail that goes into some of these walls is remarkable.
And then I know that we were talking about this earlier. Part of the idea behind why you decided on going with these guys for this neighborhood.
Yeah, when we were considering who we wanted to build our walls, it was pretty obvious to both my partner and I, Michael Cano, that we wanted Vertical Solutions to build our gym. A lot of our favorite gyms were built by them.
Yeah, I know this is kind of an upscale area in San Antonio. There's a lot of development going on here right now, and you guys are right in the middle of it. So is that part of the idea behind going with them as well?
Yeah, we felt that Vertical Solutions has the most beautiful walls on the market. There's a very warm, organic feel to them that, to me, is very inviting. It makes me want to climb there. There's that artisan look to it with the hardwood, like we talked about.
Yes.
We're kind of in a very nice, unique part of downtown San Antonio where there's a lot of high-end developments, and you know, we wanted to kind of fit in the neighborhood a little bit as best we could.
What's the neighborhood called again?
Technically, it's River North. But everybody calls this just kind of the Pearl area.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Pearl is a big redevelopment site a few blocks away from us.
That's right. They used to be an old brewery area.
Yeah,
right?
100 years ago it was a brewery, and now it's home to a lot of the top restaurants, coffee shops, the nicest hotel in San Antonio.
Yeah.
But in the same way that we try to create that community feel, the Pearl does a great job of that as well. They have events, free music, they have a farmer's market. So they attract people from all over San Antonio and diverse groups of people in the same way that we try to. So we're really fortunate to be neighbors with them.
Yeah, definitely. All right, so this area, let's see what's in here. Oh yeah, so what's this area, Joe?
We call this area the Grotto. This is our climbing training area. We have hangboards, campus board, as well as a spray wall you can see behind me, with which has another kind of San Antonio touch to it with the Virgin de Guadalupe. So a lot of our stronger climbers spend a lot of time in here. Our youth team, the Quesadillos, this is where they spend a lot of time.
That's a cool name.
Yeah. We try to have fun with it for sure. And the Quesadillos is our youth team. So
yeah.
Yeah.
And what's the age range on those guys?
The age range for them is 8 through 17.
Okay. And then what do you have over here? Let's go ahead and take a look at that. So you guys...
So you see we've got hangboards on a French cleat system, so you can move the hangboards around. We have several to choose from.
Oh, yeah. You got a selection of them over here.
Yeah.
So that kind of... compensates for any lack of space you might have. You can, instead of having these hanging all over the place, have them interchangeable.
Helps us be real efficient with the space. Yeah.
Yeah.
Behind us we have a campus board.
All right.
And some smoke for campus runs.
Oh yeah, so that's a nice board.
And behind you we have a spray wall, which has been really popular. We originally had this configured as a systems board with all wooden holds. About 4 months ago, we swapped it out, put a spray wall, and it's been really popular. We do have a few tape circuits that are good for building endurance, 25-move circuits, and people love training on those.
I bet. That looks like a good workout. This wall is...
We call this Wallito because it is our smaller wall.
A little bit shorter than the others.
A little more kid-friendly. We try to keep all of the routes without big reaches, have it a little more dense so there's lots of holds for kids to grab. So it's a great place for kids, beginners, or even just experienced climbers who want to warm up. Right now we have a few hard slab problems on there left over from our competition, so a lot of our members are enjoying that because typically we don't have hard problems over here, but when we do set some fun tricky slabs, everybody gets excited.
Talking about kids, you guys originally had birthdays that you would do, but now no longer do that.
Yeah, we have a lot of youth programs. We started off doing birthday parties, but we just decided against doing those. They were a little hard to manage sometimes in a bouldering gym.
Especially if you don't have like a designated area.
Yeah. But we do have like youth recreational classes for kids starting at age 6, which are great for after school. Those have been really popular. And a lot of those kids end up going on to our other youth programs. We have a development team, which is ages 8 through about 14.
Uh-huh.
So those are kids who are kind of interested in more team-style competition and training, but not quite at the team level. And then we have our Quesadilla youth team, which is currently at about 25 kids. And they train twice a week. And we're in the middle of bouldering season now, so just about every other weekend, they've been traveling to competitions all over the state and faring pretty well against kids from Austin, Houston, Dallas. So it's been really exciting to watch all of those kids grow.
Yeah.
So I wanted to ask you also what kind of events things that you guys do. Do you have competitions here?
Yeah, we've held several competitions. We just hosted a USA Climbing Youth Competition as well as a Citizens Competition. It's called Dilo de los Muertos. It took place on the Day of the Dead. So we had a fun time with that. Had some Dia de los Muertos decorations and things. We hosted a USA Climbing Collegiate Comp. We've done a bouldering league for adults. We did a Summer Stoke Comp Series, which is a month-long individual competition series. So we try to do a lot of events as well as competitions to really just create a lot of community, get people in, hanging out together. We do kind of quarterly member appreciation nights where we grill burgers, veggie burgers, and just have music, food, climbing, we'll play silly games. The last member night we did headlamp climbing, turned off all the lights,
oh, wow,
and filled the gym with glow sticks and headlamps, and that was a lot of fun. So anything we can do to just get people together, enjoy climbing, enjoy the community that we have here.
Yeah. Did I see something with the local colleges too, the universities? A couple of their teams or something climbing?
Yeah, so the UTSA has a climbing club and a climbing team, as well as Trinity University.
Okay.
And they both climbing here quite a bit.
So tell me about this wall, Joe. Is this got some inspiration from more cultural aspects of San Antonio, right?
Yeah. So when we were starting the gym and trying to think of ways to incorporate elements from our hometown of San Antonio, one of the images that I kept coming back to was Ballet Folklorico and the connecting climbing to dance and the choreography, the grace, the fluidity of that movement, and kind of that image of those twirling skirts coming up. And we kind of incorporated that into this wall. So this is called the dancer wall, and it's kind of inspired by, you know, those big flowy dresses as they spin around.
Yeah.
And Michael's laughing at me.
Show him demonstrate. Show him some of the flowy dances.
So who's Michael? You haven't introduced him yet.
Hey, dog. I'm Michael. I work with Joe. Joe's behind all the magic of this place. I just help support it.
Yeah, the co-owner, right?
Yeah.
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 They both did this together, folks. This is the dream team that finally made it happen for San Antonio.
So, Joe, we kind of talked about vertical solutions already in the walls. Did you guys use them for, like, your whole business setup, or can you pick and choose, like, a la carte on that, or how do you guys do it?
We did not do their business package. But to be honest, like, they were instrumental, like, the whole way of helping us with little tips. Giving advice on the industry, advice on locations, construction, design. Their team is really helpful throughout the whole process. So even though we didn't do the official business consulting package, they were still really helpful. Even up to, you know, after we were open, we could still call and just ask little questions about, oh, you know, what do we do for this? This happened. What should we do?
Yeah.
You know, we were on the phone with them a week, you know, construction was done, but we were still on the phone with them a week before finalizing pricing and things like that. So they were really helpful to work with the whole way.
Okay.
So we didn't have the official business package, but they built the walls. We have the Habit flooring, which is Vertical Solutions.
Yeah.
And the majority of the holds we started with are Habit holds, which is their hold flooring side.
Yeah.
So we got a lot of holds from them as well.
Okay. Did they have to provide a lot of input as far as, like, dealing with the city and the permits and architects and that kind of thing?
No. Yeah. Once they're outside of, you know, the state, so as far as, like, dealing with the city, they didn't, you know, do too much of that. We had a local architect who worked with that.
Okay.
They provided a engineering letter for the walls so that the city could understand the structural design and the engineering behind that. But as far as dealing with the city, that was their main input on that.
Once you guys got the location figured out, how long about did it take as far as the process?
It took us
built and opening the doors.
Yeah, so we closed on the loan. It took us about a couple months to start construction, and then about 6 months of construction till we were mostly done, and then there was another month or so of like all the little details. So in all, it took us about 7 months from construction to opening day.
Yeah, and that's going to vary for everybody because, for example, you guys, this location existed, but you had to bump up the ceiling and a big portion of it.
Yeah, we did a lot of work. The building had like good bones, but we needed all new electrical, HVAC, a lot of new plumbing. We popped up the roofs, added a lot of new steel, so there was a lot of heavy lifting we had to do even before, you know, the wall builders come in. So.
Yeah, I really love the walls. I like the flooring system. I haven't seen their flooring system before, but what do you think of it? Do you like it?
It's been great, yeah. Yeah.
And it's more like a firm floor.
It's a little more firm than some gyms, which according to some research is a little bit better for impact and safety, you know, maybe less injuries.
Yeah. I know there's give and take on both sides.
Yeah.
Depending on how you fall and all.
How you
kind
fall,
of stuff.
The height, whether you're landing on your back or on your feet. And if you're, you know, we do a safety orientation with everybody that comes in. And one of the things we teach them is how to fall safely. We want to limit injuries as much as possible, limit long term impact. You know, I feel it in my knees sometimes. I've been climbing for 20 years. I've taken a lot of falls onto gym pads, on the crash pads outside, on the bare ground. So we want people to know how to fall safely. It's just as important as knowing how to climb.
Thank you for taking the time to check out this video. I hope you found it informative and entertaining. If I missed anything that you feel is important or would like to see in future videos, please let me know in the comments. Again, my goal is to make this a channel for the community. Also, please subscribe and hit the bell if you want to be notified about future uploaded videos. And don't forget to take time to like or dislike this video so that YouTube knows how you feel about the content. And I'll see you in the next video, hopefully in a week or so. Thank you again.